Welcome back to Heart of Carolina Perspectives. Every year, thousands of people die or sustain life-threatening injuries in fires. The best way to prevent these injuries and fatalities is through proper fire safety precautions and the installation of working smoke alarms. This is the 11th year that ABC 11 has teamed up with KIDA, the J.C. Byrne Center at UNC Hospitals, and fire departments all around the area for Operation Save a Life. One of the cornerstones of Operation Save a Life is the distribution of smoke alarms to people in need. This year, with the help of KIDA, we hope to get more than 4,100 alarms into homes all around the Heart of Carolina. So joining me now to talk more about this Operation Save Life, we have Heather Caldwell from KIDA and then Dr. Bruce Cairns from the J.C. Byrne Center at UNC Hospitals. Thank you both for coming in today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so Heather, let's talk about smoke alarms. It certainly seems as though it's something simple. We all know we should have them, but how often do we see homes without them?
Unfortunately, too often. About 20% of homes across the U.S. do not have working smoke alarms in them, and that's a lot when you consider that these are a very simple device that it doesn't take much time at all to put up in your home, and that could save lives. In fact, unfortunately, fire experts nationally just released that fire deaths in 2013 actually have increased 16%. So there's still a lot of work to do to get smoke alarms in homes because we know working smoke alarms can help save lives.
And Dr. Cairns, you see this firsthand in many cases. People who come in, what are the extent of injuries that you typically see possibly resulting from fires that could have been prevented?
It's just a tragic injury. And we do a lot of things at the Byrne Center, but our most important mission is to prevent the injury itself. If we could be put out of business, that would be the best thing ever. And we are so proud of our partnership with KIDA in the distribution and TB11 in the distribution of these smoke alarms, because it really does save lives. In an instant, you can get an injury that you'll have to live with for the rest of your life and possibly lose your life and the lives of your loved ones. So it's really important that you have smoke alarms, carbon monoxide detectors, you have a plan, because even though it may seem like you have time, you really don't, and a very large injury can occur within seconds.
Well, yeah, I was going to ask you, how much time do you have? I think there's this misconception. I'll smell the fire, I will notice the fire, I'll have time to react properly, but we know that's not always the case.
What we find is that people, if they've not thought about this ahead of time, they'll react, and usually when they react, they'll make a decision that really is not a good one. And so it's important to think ahead of time, and one of those concepts is really to have a working smoke alarm. And it's very important that there are relatively simple steps that you can take, and KIDA does a great job in getting the word out as to how you can do this and prevent this injury.
Yeah, so Heather, what are the steps? I mean, and you are boiling this down to make it super simple for families.
Yes, Caitlin, we're all super busy and we have so much on our mind, but really, especially with October being Fire Safety Month, the families just take a little bit of time and do four simple things. One, they need to check their smoke alarms, make sure they have smoke alarms on every floor and inside and outside of bedrooms, and make sure that the smoke alarms are under 10 years old. A lot of people out there have smoke alarms over 10 years old. They need to be replaced. Mm-hmm. Two, have CO alarms, carbon monoxide alarms, on each floor of their home. Have a fire extinguisher in rooms where fires often start, like the kitchen and the garage. And finally, sit down with your family and have an escape plan. The smoke alarm is going to help provide that early warning, but you also need to know what to do when that alarm sounds, because you really do not have a lot of time.
Yeah, like we just heard Dr. Cairns saying, having that plan in place beforehand makes a world of difference. Tell me about the smoke alarms that you're giving out. These are pretty exceptional, right?
We're really excited about this smoke alarm. We are donating over 4,100 smoke alarms to Heart of Carolina fire departments through Operation Save a Life. And what's great about these smoke alarms is they have a 10-year sealed-in battery. So that means that once these smoke alarms are installed, they will provide nonstop protection, nonstop power for 10 years. Now, you still want to test the smoke alarm every month just to make sure it's operating correctly, but don't have to replace the battery, and you don't have to hear that low battery chirp in the middle of the night.
And you did mention having detectors also for carbon monoxide and the dangers that presents, because isn't that really what incapacitates people before even the fire itself?
It really does. And most people who lose their life lose it from carbon monoxide poisoning, and so they really go hand in hand. And we're actually one of the largest burn centers from between DC and Atlanta. And it's because we have so many fires here in North Carolina. And it really is important that we do everything we can to prevent them. And we are really proud, again, of our partnership with KIDA, because not only are they saving lives with the smoke detectors and the carbon monoxide detectors, but they also are helping support our staff, particularly our nurses, in delivering the best possible care to the people who do get injured. We had a record number of admissions last year. We're on track to do that again in line with the data that we have more people losing their lives from fire this year. It is so important that you have a working smoke alarm in your house.
Well, we appreciate your efforts treating patients and KIDA's efforts helping to prevent, and that's really what this is all about. So thank you both so very much for coming in and sharing the message. Obviously, a lot will be going on in October, and of course, we're going to post all that information on abc11.com so people can learn more about these efforts and what's going on to spread the message. So thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Well, thank you so much for joining Heart of Carolina Perspectives. A reminder, you can find all of that information we were just talking about from the rest of our show, ABC 11 Together page at abc11.com. We leave you with a look at some great community events that are coming up soon.